Google Ads Enhanced Conversion is a feature that can enhance the accuracy of your conversion measurement and unlock more powerful bidding. Hey, my name is Abid. In this video, I will show you how to set up Google Ads Enhanced Conversion on your Shopify with Google Tag Manager. So without further delay, let's begin learning. To get started, the first thing you need to do is go to Google Ads and create a purchase conversion. This step is crucial because it provides us with additional parameters that we'll need to include in Google Tag Manager. Select Goals, Summary, and select New Conversion Action. Select Website and enter your website domain. And select Scan. Go down and select Add a Conversion Action manually. And after select conversion action manually, just select the category. Now my goal is purchase, that's why I'm choosing purchase, and enter your conversion name. My conversion name is complete purchase, and select the use different values for each conversion because we are setting the dynamic Google Ads conversion. That's why we have to choose the different value and go down. Everything is okay, just done. And go down, save and continue. And here is the interactions. And just select the use Google Tag Manager. And you will get the conversion ID and the complete purchase the conversion label. And copy this conversion ID. And go to Google Tag Manager. And go to variables. And select user defined variables, select new and variable configuration. Go down, select the constant and enter your conversion ID, enter conversion ID name and save this. Again, go to the Google Ads and select the conversion label. And again, go to Google Tag Manager and create another new variables. You can select constant and paste it here and enter conversion variable name. The name will be the conversion label and save this and go to tags and select new tags and select tag configuration. Select Google Ads conversion. You can see here is the sum field is showing is conversion ID, conversion label, value, transaction ID and currency. We have to create these variables for Google Ads conversion. Before creating variables, we need to push a Shopify data layer on our store. Shopify data layer is a JavaScript code. This is our Shopify data layer and Shopify data layer is provide the user information and product information is dynamic. That's why we have to use this JavaScript code. Go to your Shopify store and select themes and select the edit code. And we have to copy your Google Tag Manager ID. And copy this script and go to the Shopify backend, select theme.liquid and just paste it here, your Google Tag Manager code and save this and exit and again go to settings and select the checkout and go down. You will see here is the additional script box. Now again go to the Google Ads Enhanced Conversion document and select the checkout code, select all and copy and paste it here and replace the GTM ID with your GTM container ID. And save this. Our Shopify data layer setup is done. Now we have to create some variables for customer information and the three variables for purchase information. let's create. Just copy and go to Google Tag Manager and select the variables. And again, select the user defined variables, select new, and variable configuration, select the data layer variable. And the data layer variable name will be the customer email. And just select this variable and paste it here and save this. Again, we have to create for more 7 variables. The same process. Customer information variable created is done. Now we have to create these 3 variables for purchase information. Just again copy this variable name and again go to data layer variable and paste it here. And purchase event variable created is done. Now again go to Google Tag Manager and select the again variable and variable configuration. Go down and you will see here is the user provided data, and you can see here is the user provided data field. We will use this user provided variable data for Google Ads Enhanced, and we have already created this variable. And if I select the email, you can see here is our email variable. Just select this again, the phone variable and the first name, last name. And I have added variable and just save this. You can also write this name, user provide data for Google Ads, and save this. User provide data variable created is done. Now we need to create a triggers. Go to the triggers and the key triggers name will be the purchase. This is our event name. Select the triggers new configuration and select the custom event. Event name will be the purchase and the trigger name also will be the purchase, and save this. And go to tags. Again, select the new and the tag configuration. And select the Google Ads and select the Google Ads conversion tracking. And select the conversion ID. And select the conversion label. And select the conversion value, DLB conversion value, and select the transaction ID, and again select the currency. We need to select the include user provide data from your website. Select the user provide data, and you can see here is our user provide data variable for Google Ads. Just select this and select the trigger. And trigger will be the purchase, and enter any name, Google Ads conversion tracking, purchase, and save this. Now our Google Ads conversion tracking created done. Just submit this container and publish this. Now we will test our Google Ads enhanced conversion. Now select the preview and enter your website URL and select connect. And Google Tag Manager is connected. If I go to the Tag Assistant, you can see here is the connected and everything is working. And now we have to select the some product. Just select the add to cart. And if I select the multiple products, again if I select add to cart, select the checkout, select pay now, and order confirmation is done and Tag Assistant it's connected. If I go to the Tag Assistant connected, and you can see here is our purchase event is fired. If I select the variables, you can see here is our all variables is working. Customer country, customer email, first name, last name, and the customer phone number is not working because my website have no phone number field. That's why. Here is the postal code, region, state, everything working. And you can see here is our user provide data variable also working. And you can see here is the data layer. We have already set up this data layer on our Shopify store. And if I go to the tags, I select the Google Ads conversion tracking purchase. You can see here is the enhanced conversion showing. This is our first name, last name, state, city, everything is sending to Google Ads. And if I select the show more, now it's perfect. Here is showing the transaction ID. And this is the conversion value is 146.5. It's now working perfect. And that's it. Our Google Ads enhanced conversion setup is done. Thank you for watching this tutorial on setting up Google Ads enhanced conversion on Shopify with Google Tag Manager. If you found this video useful, please show your support by hitting the thumbs up button below. And if you are eager to learn more about Google Tag Manager or Google Analytics, consider subscribing to my channel. I'm Abid and I look forward to seeing you in our next video. Until then, take care. Have a great day.